food. We are the Smothers Brothers, and we're so happy to be here with you high-energy people and achievers and with enthusiasm. We are the Smothers Brothers, and we're happy to be here at your convention, a Usana convention. We, of course, we're not the original Smothers Brothers. The original Smothers Brothers, of course, passed away in 1969. Terrible plane crash.
Stop that. That's not...
One of them wasn't a pilot.
Now that's sick. Will you stop that? Why are you laughing at that? That's a sick joke. I don't like that.
We are the Smothers Brothers. I'm Tom, and this is my brother Dick. That's happy to be here. And we have been around a long time, and that's why I mentioned which brother I am. I'm Tom, and this is Dick. I'm Tom. I play the guitar. My brother Dick plays the bass, and we have been around a long time. And sometimes people, they know who the Smothers Brothers, but they're not quite sure which one is which. And they see one of us by ourselves, they'll invariably make the mistake of calling us by the wrong name. They'll call me Dick. They'll call him Tom. But I'm Tom, and it's like... this is my brother Dick. Everly brothers, same thing happened with the Everly brothers, Don and Phil Everly. They call Don Phil, and he just say, "I'll take a message. I'm Don." But Phil hardly ever was called Don, but Don more often was mistaken for Phil. I can't figure that out. But I'm Tom. I play the guitar. This is my one night. I made a mistake. I said, I was saying who we were. I'm Tom, I play the guitar, and this is my Dick, he plays the bass. I forgot it. This is my brother.
Will you stop that?
That's so stupid.
Well, don't say it again. I mean, that was bad enough the first... actually said... Well, I hope you have it all straight. He's Tom, and for tonight's performance, I'll be Richard, and I play the bass. Thank you very much. And we'd like to start off the show, really, with a song. I think it's a beautiful song. It's a love song, and that's what I feel in this room. Love. It's an international song, meaning it's a Latin American in origin. And after all, the world
had
is...
Had an old dog, and his name was Blue. Bet's $5 is a good dog, too. Had an old dog, and his name was Blue. Whoa, whoa, hey, now you're a good dog, too.
Are you finished?
Nope.
Thank you.
Old Jack Frost on the bottom of the dog. Old Jack Frost on the bottom of the dog. Froze that dog to the ground. Froze that dog to the ground. Well, he couldn't get up. He couldn't get around, but he sure knew how to lay down. Doo-doo.
Okay, no applause is necessary. That's a junk song. Doesn't belong in the show. So what we'd like to do is sing this Latin American love song for you.
Now that I know that you like dog songs, here's a dog song.
Oh, no.
Never mind. Jimmy cracked corn and I don't care. Jimmy cracked corn and I don't care. I don't care. I don't care.
Wait a minute. That's not the way the song goes.
I don't care.
Why not?
I don't know.
Then why sing it?
I can't remember.
You can't remember?
And I don't know. I had the vision once, but... Nope, I don't. I don't have it anymore. I used to have it, but I don't know, and I don't care.
Well, you're acting like a stupid fool.
That's my job.
Yeah. And you're doing a great job.
Thank you very much.
That's not a compliment. Now, what we like to do is sing this Latin American
sounded
love song.
Like a compliment.
Well, it was not a compliment.
But you did say I was doing a good job.
I absolutely do. That's what I said.
You said you do not. You said, Tom, you're doing a great job, and I just said, thank you very much.
You took the meaning out of context.
No, but it sounded like a compliment. I know there was a lot of compliments given tonight, and I know even in our lives, in our personal lives, families sometimes forget because we know each other so well, and sometimes we forget to give a compliment, which is a symbolic bouquet, a dewdrop of love, of respect, and so often we forget to share a compliment, just a casual compliment. So when I heard you say you're doing a great job, I thought it was a compliment.
It was not a compliment, but your point is well taken. It's good to give compliments if they're deserved. So you'd be on a compliment alert. If you deserve one, I'll give it to you. Now, this particular song is a Latin American love song. It's beloved worldwide, and there's very few songs that I think that could be fit in that small, select category, and it's not really... For this kind of music, to understand the words, because the emotional feeling is obvious. And I would like to dedicate this beautiful song to all the lovers in this audience tonight. Hope you enjoy it. It's entitled, Cuando Caliente el Sol. Cuando caliente el sol, aquí en la playa, siento tu
cuerpo vibra cerca de mí. Es tu palpitar, es tu cara, es tu pelo, son tus besos, mi estremezco. Cuando calienta el sol aquí en la playa, siento tu cuerpo vibrar cerca de mí. Es tu palpitar, tu mi cuerpo, mi locura, mi delirio, mi estremezco. Oh, oh, oh. Playa. Siento tu cuerpo vibrar cerca de mí. Es tu palpitar, es tu cara, es tu pelo, son tus besos, mi estremezco. Oh, oh, oh.
Schlafen unter Straußen. Oh, cuando calienta el sol aquí en la playa, siento tu cuerpo vibrar cerca de mí.
Smothers. A little louder, please. Everybody, la 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 la, come on, let's hear ya. La 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 la, come on now. ¿Qué pasa? ¿Por qué no música? Un momento, yo tengo problema con mi amigo porque él no cantar, no música. Un momento, ni habla con mi amigo. El de aquí. Señor Dicky. Yo trabajo mucho con mucho música, pero óigame, nada. Todo silencio, ¿por qué no música? Usted tiene la boca aquí, dos las bocas, dos hermanos, dos hombres, dos las bocas, pero todo silencio. Óigame, nada. Ricardo. Comprende, todas personas aquí, muchas personas aquí, no comprendemos por qué Ricardo no música, por qué no música. El gato tiene el tango. Muy comédico. Ricardo, comprende, yo tengo... Su hermano, me llamo Tomás, yo tengo guitarra. Mi guitarra tiene música. Ah, Rhino. No boom boom.
Pain in the ass.
No comprendo.
Yeah.
Maybe did okay. No comprendo.
Now that was a great. That was a great response on my brother's part. It really was.
Muchas gracias.
That was not a compliment, but it was a great response. And you know why? It's the first truthful words he's spoken tonight on this stage. I don't understand. I don't comprehend. That's a great leap forward.
No es verdad. Comprendo todos. Cuando calienta el sol aquí en la playa, comprendo todas las palabras, habla español.
I think, just a second, I think it's very important you all know he doesn't understand Spanish. You can speak and not understand it, that's just rote memorization.
No,
most of those words are just nonsense syllables as far as my brother's concerned. He's a fake and a fraud.
El toro crapo.
That's right. What did you say?
El toro crapo.
You don't even know what it means.
Oh, bullshit.
All right, now you stop that. You stop. Now, please, do not laugh at that kind of language. Really, you're just going to reinforce unacceptable behavior on my brother's part. And that was very... Wipe that smirk off your face. I resent that. Wipe it off. You keep it off. You've got nothing to be proud about. You know what you've done. You wrecked that song. A beloved song, a love song, beloved and tender and full of feeling. You heard me dedicate it to the lovers in this audience. Tom, look at me. Look at me. I'm talking to you. Look at me. I was counting on you to finish it. I was counting on you to finish the song.
Bad judgment on your part.
He's right. He's absolutely right.
Thanks. Finally a compliment.
That's not a compliment. Why don't you tell everyone why you wrecked that song? I'm curious. Why did you do it? Why did you wreck the song?
The piano player told me to wreck it.
That's not true. The piano player is a very dedicated musician. You heard him play at the top of the show. He creates music.
The piano player came to me just before the start of the we were coming on right at the final Vision Awards. He was backstage. He came to me, said, "Tom, officially authorized to tell you to make sure that the Cuando Caliente el Sol song has no ending, that you wreck the ending of the song. You don't finish it, and I've been authorized to give you this information."
Well, why? Why would anybody want you to...
I'm not involved. A piano player came to me and he said he was authorized...
Hold it. You're the one who is involved, not us. And I want to know, did you ask him why? Before you wrecked it, were you curious? Were you at all curious?
He was authorized.
Were you at all curious as to the reason?
Yes.
Did you ask him why?
I said to him, why? Mm-hmm. He said, "Tom, you're simply an instrument of policy. You don't make policy. I've been officially authorized. If you want to be part of the..." He said, "If you want to be part of the team, you'll follow this official policy and you'll do as official policy has been authorized. You will, if you want to be part of the New World Vision and the..." He says, "You'll follow this authorized policy and you will not be held accountable. You have deniability, and you'll not be held responsible for implementing this official policy."
How can you stand on this stage, do something so stupid, and then deny it?
I'm an American.
I guess that says it all. Michael, do you hear what Tom has to say? Tom's blaming you. He claims he has a deniability and you don't. And I know you just wouldn't do such a thing, would you? Well, I'd be speechless too, Michael, if I was in your position. You heard Tommy say you told him to wreck the song, but I know. I really know. You didn't do it, did you? Well, did you? Yes or no?
Therefore, I'm not involved. The piano player told me to do it, and I did it. The piano.
Do you do everything the piano player tells you to do? You do?
Yes.
Would you jump off a bridge if the piano player told you to do it?
Not again.
I wouldn't bet on that one. We'd like to change the pace a little bit for you right now and sing for you a song I think qualifies as an inspirational song. The lyrics were designed to give you that extra strength that we all need in our lives from time to time. Get over those rough spots. Keep on going. I think that's a powerful message. Beautiful song, and we hope you like it.
Excuse me, Dick. I'd like to dedicate this song also to anyone in the audience who plays the game of golf. Anybody that's ever played the game of golf, I think this is a song that's inspirational for golfers also.
To dream the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable fall, to bear with unbearable sorrow, to run the brave fear to go. This is my quest, to follow that star. No matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right without question or pause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. At my heart will I peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest.
The Impossible Dream from the Broadway show Man of La Mancha. It tells the story of the brave, the courageous Don Quixote. And in this song, The Impossible Dream, it tells of his quest, his impossible dream, his vision, his courage. I think that this song has a message for every single person here tonight. In fact, this song has a message for every single living person in the entire world. Tom, what is the message this song sends to you?
I'm sorry, I wasn't paying attention. I don't know there was going to be a message.
I wasn't paying attention. You didn't know there was going to be a message? That is the most perfect answer. It is perfect, because that's the reason we don't all receive life's messages at precisely the same time. We don't know there's anything out there. We're not listening. But when we do listen, when we do focus on life's messages, we generally get them. Like the one in this song is simple, isn't it? It's just fight for what you believe in. Simple message, yet very difficult to do sometimes. Fight for what you believe in. But if you believe in something strong enough, and it can help make this world a better place, and it is important to you, then no matter what the odds, no matter what the possible outcome, if you stand straight and tall and fight for your convictions, then you'll be the winner, no matter what the result. Because you'll be the winner in life, because you tried, you did your best, you gave it your all. And you know what? This world would be a better place. More people would do just that.
That's beautiful.
Starting with you tonight on this stage, focus in on the impossible dream and tell everyone here tonight what it means to you.
The impossible dream. And what does it mean to me? what does the impossible dream mean to each of us? I'm asking you, what does this mean? Is there such a thing as an impossible dream? We all dream. We all have the most outrageous dreams, so an impossible dream is probably very possible and probably very common. But in this case, I think what my brother means is when the dream has been dreamt, the dreamt dream, after the dream's been dreamt, what? The question is, can you take that dream into reality and make this dream become a reality? And if it seems difficult and all but impossible to accomplish, go back to sleep. Dream another dream. But when I think of this song, when I think of the impossible dream, I think of America. Because America truly was an impossible dream come true. It was just an idea, a concept. When we look around the world today, we say, what an incredible dream America is and was. It was just an idea, a concept. And it became a reality because people passionately believed in this concept, in this idea. Men like Thomas Jefferson, Benjamin Franklin, George Washington. I think all of us know the first story we know of learn about our country is about George Washington and the cherry tree. He chopped down a cherry tree. George Washington chopped down a cherry tree, then wandered away, didn't say anything. But when confronted with this cherry tree chopping incident, George Washington said, "I cannot tell a lie, I did it." It's pretty profound. George Washington said, "I cannot tell a lie." Richard Nixon said, "I cannot tell the truth." Bill Clinton said, "I cannot tell the difference." But there's always hope.
And this world.
There's hope because as Americans, we have the freedom to reach into the toolbox of ideas. If that toolbox is half empty, we have the freedom to reach into someone else's toolbox.
This last ounce of courage,
so we have the tools
to dream.
So let's always remember, swing slow, keep your head down, and follow through.
The impossible dream. Impossible dream. Thank you. Thank you all.